He helped popularize musical terms like punk rock and heavy metal. He's been called America's greatest rock critic and was fired from Rolling Stone magazine for being too mean to the bands. Contrarian and Cantankerous. Do you know Lester Bangs?
You know, rock as theater is the same old music, the same old gunk dressed up in new clothes.
For some, the most well-known cultural touchstone for Bangs is the largely adored Cameron Crowe film Almost Famous, where Bangs was portrayed by Philip Seymour Hoffman.
Live American woman. Have you ever the most brilliant piece of gobbledygook ever?
For others, it's Bangs' revered and widely shared essay about Van Morrison's Astral Weeks. For Lester's biggest fans, it's everything he ever wrote. Born December 14, 1948, Bangs was raised a Jehovah's Witness in a household that prohibited doctors, booze, dancing, and drugs. Slowly breaking himself free from these restrictions, Bangs turned to rock and roll and Romilar cough syrup poured over LSD. In 1969, his first dream came true. He was hired as a writer by Rolling Stone magazine. Bangs knocked around his typewriter night after night, churning out insightful, funny, and brutal reviews of the music he loved so much, but refused to blindly worship.
He said, well, you know, there was Sinatra in the 40s, and there was Elvis in the 50s, and the Beatles in the 60s, and now's the time, and that was 2 years ago, and nothing has happened.
Rolling Stone founder Jan Venner fired Bangs from the magazine for disrespecting musicians after he turned in a particularly mean-spirited Canned Heat review. Bangs next became editor of Cream magazine in 1971, moving to Detroit. His series of interviews with his musical hero, the Velvet Underground's Lou Reed, function like a series of hilarious and vicious rounds of a verbal boxing match. They are, like much of Bangs' writing, like nothing else in the world of music journalism.
Nothing is going on right now, and people are desperate.
Bangs died in New York City on April 30, 1982, at the age of 33, of an accidental overdose of Dexys, diazepam, and NyQuil. His life story, greatest hits, and most outrageous stories can all be heard in the play How to Be a Rock Critic.